Hello guys, I hope you all are healthy and self-isolated. As you all know, due to lockdown, we are not able to come to college. So here we are for the lecture of steel structure. We are going to design a plate girder. Now this is a part first, and we are going to do it in two or three parts. Excuse the surrounding voices. Let's start. Now before we jump into design of plate girder, I want to remind you about the design of gantry girder. You must all know about the gantry girder design. We have done it in the class. So I want to show you the picture of gantry girder first. Here is a gantry girder. Now, as I say gantry girder, what comes in your mind? That gantry girder is a beam. Gantry girder is a beam which supports the crane girder over, which supports the crane girder. So, now I am saying plate girder. Now it must be a beam. Yes, it is a beam. But what kind of differences are there? What is the difference between the gantry girder and plate girder? As we already designed the gantry girder, then why are we designing the plate girder separately? So there is a difference. Gantry girder is a whole section. Gantry girder is a whole section, rolled steel section, which is manufactured in the factory. Girder also manufactured in the factory, but the gantry girder is designed and governed by IS specification. But in the plate girder, we adapt the different sections, like solid plate, angles, channel section. We adapt different sections separately and made a I-beam together with different components by welding or bolting together. So that is a plate girder. So what is the difference? Plate girder is made of different or separate components of steel section, that is known as plate girder. Let's look forward. Here is plate girder. Now you can see the plates are here. These plates are working as flanges here, and this is the wave plate. So what we have done, we bind up together these different components, these different sections in a single whole section, which is called a beam, and we know it as a plate girder. Now we will check out some different images here. See, this is also a plate girder. Here wave, this is wave, and these are flanges, the bottom flange and the top flange, and this hole, it is a span. It is known as a span. And the other components you can see here are these are stiffeners. We will talk about that later. but these are stiffeners, these are vertical stiffeners. And there is also we design horizontal stiffeners like that. So look forward here, what is a plate girder? So plate girder are typically I-beam made up from separate structural steel rather than rolled as a single cross section, which are welded or bolted or riveted together to form web and flanges of the beam. And these can be provided for larger span over 20 meter made with provision of extra cover plates. What does it mean? That usually where we need larger span and more strength of beam, there we design plate girder. On the depend of the situation, we can design a different beam, so it can bear the condition, it can bear the load from there. So an image should be form up in your mind when I say plate girder. Now we will see some different images also. See, here is a 2D section of plate girder. As you can see, the way plate at the bottom flange, this is a top flange with cover plate and we call it flange. Here is the angle available here, and here is side plate also available. So let's see another image here. Now as you see, horizontal stiffeners are also designed in this plate girder. As usually this is a flange, this is flange, this is web plate, and these are vertical stiffeners. Now let's see some, we can see different sections here. Now here is a section, here is a girder called bolted without cover plates. What we have done here, we jointed two angle section and two angle section as a flange and a solid plate as a web plate. Now what is ISA? ISA, Indian Standard Angle. Now in the second section, bolted with cover plate, we have also added a cover plate here. And in the third, these are bolted, but it is welded. You can see flat weld. Now these are welded section and these are bolted section. Okay, let's see another type of plate girder, which we call box girder. This type of girder can be seen on the deck type of bridges. These are more stronger than others. As you can see, we have also added side plates here to strengthening the load capacity of the plate girder in the girder with side plate. Now we move on to the design concept. How can we design it? So to design the plate girder, we will take an example and solve it step by step, and the concept will also be discussed there. So let's see the example. Here is the example. It says, design a plate girder for simply supported bridge deck floor with clear span 24 meters, subjected to dead load of 20 kN per meter, excluding self weight, live load 10 kN per meter, and two concentrated loads 200 kN each at 6 meters from each end. We have also given, assume that the top compression flange of plate girder is restrained laterally and prevented from rotating. Use Fe415 grade of steel design as an unstiffened plate girder with thick web. Now in this condition, it says restrain laterally beam. What does it mean? We have designed beam in the last semesters, where we designed laterally supported beam, laterally unsupported beam. Now this is that kind of condition. Now it is given us as a normal condition. Now what is the given data here? First we write the given data. So clear span 24 meters, dead load 20 kN per meter excluding self weight, live load 10 kN per meter, and two concentrated load at 6 meter from each end, that is 200 kN, and the condition is laterally restrained Fe415 grade. In the first step, we always do the load calculation. So in the load calculation, our concept arrived that self weight of girder can be assumed. In the question, we have not the self weight of the girder. So from the empirical formula, it is total factor load, it is total factor load divided by 200 kN per meter. So total factor load, what will be the total factor load? The load which are coming on the girder. So we will calculate the factored load. So we must have known about the total load. So total factored load on girder will be 1.5 multiplied by total load. And what is total load? 20, dead load 10, live load multiplied by span, that is 24, and other two loads 200 kN multiplied by 1.5. Now this is the total factored load. Now we have to determine the self weight. So we will divide it by 200 from this formula. So 1680 divided by 200 will become 8.4 kN per meter. Now we have got that self weight of the girder. Now what will we do? We need to draw a loading diagram so we can further determine the shear force and bending moment. So first we need total load which are coming on the girder. So total load calculated as, see, it is the total UDL on girder. So 20 dead load will be counted as a UDL, live load will be counted as UDL, and also the self weight of the girder. So it becomes 38.4 kilonewton per meter. Now we will multiply it by 1.5 to factor it. So here 1.5 multiply by 38.4, it becomes 57.6 kilonewton per meter. Now say assume it 58 kilonewton per meter. Now we have also other two loads, those concentrated load. So here 1.5 multiply by 200, so it become 300 kilonewton. So now we will see the loading diagram here. Here the beam, AB, and the two concentrated load that was 200, and we factored it, and these became 300 kilonewton from each end. Here is the center point E, and this is the UDL. So this UDL 58 kilonewton per meter. Okay, now the second step, we calculate shear force and bending moment. Now what can you see in this diagram, that where will be the shear force maximum? This is a symmetric condition. If I cut it from here, from the E, this part and this part will be same. So we will first determine the reaction, that is RA and RB. Let's see. From figure A, reaction at end point A and B, say RA and RB. So each reaction will be total load divided by 2. Why? Because total load, no movement here, only UDL and two concentrated load. So total load divided by 2 will become 58 multiplied by 24. This is here. RA, RB, total load. This UDL, is 58. The total span is 24. 58 multiplied by 24 plus 300 and 300. So RA and RB is 996 kilonewton. And the shear force, what will be the shear force, the maximum shear force? The maximum shear force will be here at the end of A or at the B point. So the maximum shear force from the geometry will occur either point A or either point B. So here maximum shear force VZ will be 996 kilonewton. Now we will calculate the maximum bending moment. Let's see the figure again. Here we are going to calculate maximum bending moment. Let's see. Let's calculate the bending moment at center point E. then we will calculate the bending moment here and then here. So E, that is the center point, ME will be, this is the reaction, so reaction multiplied by, we are determining the bending moment at the center point, so either side is equal to 12 meter, because the whole span is 24 meter, so the one side of span is 12 meter. So 996 multiplied by 12 meter minus, now the UDL 58 multiplied by 12 and 6, and the concentrated load 300 multiplied by 6, this will become 5976 kilonewton into meter. Now this is the bending moment at point E. Now bending moment at C and D, let's see the image here. We are going to determine the bending moment at C and D point. Now let's check the what will be the value. Why these are equal, MC and MD? Because this is a symmetric loading, and the either side of the moment at the point will be equal. So 996, the reaction multiplied by 6, this is the beam and we are determining it here. So this is the C point and these are the reactions. So 996 multiplied by 6, and the UDL are here, here are UDL, so 58 multiplied by 6 into 3, this will become 4932 kilonewton into meter. So as we can see, the maximum bending moment is occurring at midpoint. We can also say from the shear force location that where is the shear force is changing sign or minimum, there will be maximum bending moment. So let's draw the shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. We have determined it 5976. So shear force diagram, here is the shear force diagram. This is the loading diagram, and we have determined the maximum shear force, the reactions 996 and the shear force diagram, and the shear force diagram will be like this, and this is the bending moment diagram, the maximum and the point C and D. Okay guys, it was the first part. Now in the second part we will do this third step, where we will choose the sections. Okay, see you in the next video.